Wow. Right. So. That was much better. That was much better. Liverpool end their four-game losing streak with a 2-0 win against bottom-of-the-table Sheffield United. It doesn't matter who it's against. When you're in this position, in the position that we're in, it doesn't matter who it's against as long as you get over the line. The good thing is, we kept a clean sheet as well. We scored two goals, we kept a clean sheet, we got all 3 points. It doesn't really get much better than that. And of course, we would have liked to go on and score a few more. Had we have taken our chances, of course, that would have happened. But it doesn't matter. A win is a win, no matter how much you win by. 1-0, 2-0, 3-0, 4-0. That makes no difference as long as you get over the line in the end. Just before I go through player edges and stuff like that, I want to say Curtis Jones is one of the most underrated footballers in the world right now. And I'm saying it right now. I don't care if you're a Liverpool fan or if you're a Liverpool hater. If you deny the fact that Curtis Jones is one of the most underrated players in the world, you are a dick. I'll say that now. He's only 20 years old and he's a regular first team player. Of course, it might just be because of the injuries. Who knows? But he shouldn't be taken out of that team when everyone's back injured. Imagine him back in the team. Imagine a midfield three of Henderson, Fabinho or Thiago, and Curtis Jones. The options that we're going to have in midfield next year, especially if we bring in, Rodrigo De Paul. We're going to have so many options in that midfield to rotate with. It's going to be so good. I was a little bit concerned when I didn't see Diogo Jota on the bench. Then I found out that he was ill, which doesn't help. Apparently it's appendicitis, which can make him out for about a month, which is just what we need right now. The other thing I was concerned about coming into this game was when I seen that Adrian was on the pitch. He was in the starting 11, and neither Kelleher nor Alisson were on the bench. I knew Alisson wasn't going to be involved anyway, but when I seen that Kelleher wasn't in the team at all, I was really concerned. And I've never heard of... I'm going to butcher this pronunciation... Orzinski. I'm going to guess Orzinski. I'm going to guess the J is silent. Orzinski. Jakub Orzinski. Who, according to One Football, is apparently 51 years old. I've checked it. He's not. He's 18. I doubt we have a 51-year-old player currently playing for us, because apparently our other substitute goalkeeper is also 51, born on the same day. I believe he is also 18. Northern Ireland international. That is a name that's much easier to pronounce, Liam Hughes. But I thought, as a team, they were really good today. A few talking points. Kabak and Phillips need more practice at playing together. They looked a bit shaky at times today. And they were getting caught out a few times, especially when Oliver Burke. His pace was really, really troubling, particularly Nat Phillips. And Kabak needs to be careful. He scored an own goal in the first half. He's very lucky McBurnie was in an offside position, because that would have been 1-0 at half-time. Much more difficult to come back from. Another thing I'll say is that Firmino needs to shoot more often. He gets himself into a lot of good positions, Firmino. But he's too unselfish. And he tries to play the ball across for his other teammates. You're a striker. You've got to take the shot on. And that is exactly what Liverpool fans mean when they say, he's not a striker. Stop playing him as a striker. It's because of how unselfish he is. You can tell. He's more like Thiago, a creative midfielder who likes to provide. But he's not a number nine. I thought Mane was all right today. He looked better than he was in the last few games. He was actually using his pace. He was trying to get forward. But once again, it was his passing that was letting him down at times, Mane. And he wasn't getting into the scoring positions that he was against the likes of Everton and the likes of who did we lose to before that. Was it Brighton before that? No, there was an away game, wasn't there? I can't remember. I can't be asked to go through the whole thing. And it's the same as Salah. I thought Salah was trying to do a little bit too much by himself, in my opinion. And he needs to utilise the team. My mum made a good statement earlier. She said that Firmino's unselfish sometimes and Salah's selfish sometimes. She says that they need to swap. Firmino needs to be the selfish one. Salah needs to be the provider. He's coming in from the wings. Get the ball into Firmino, who needs to be the finisher. Will he? No, I don't think he will. He's a creative midfielder. He's not a striker. The last thing I'm quickly going to say is that, once again, I wasn't particularly impressed with one Mr. Alcantara. I thought he was, well, subpar, if I'm being honest. I thought he was average. He wasn't bad, he just wasn't... He just doesn't look like someone you'd spend 30 million on. Or at least not today. Okay, there is one more thing I want to say. Adrian was brilliant today. And that's the first time I've said that since the first game he played in, which was against Norwich last season. That's the first time I've said Adrian was brilliant today for a long, long time. It wasn't actually that long ago. I'm exaggerating. I can tell you it's the first time this season I've said Adrian played well. I can tell you that. But he was amazing, Adrian. So let's go through player ratings then. Adrian, 8. Made some brilliant saves. He was rushing out to beat pacey strikers like McBurnie to the ball. Hang on. I have received a message. Give me a second. Okay. But yeah. He was coming out of his goal to try and smash it away. He was making some good saves. He was making himself big to deny Sheffield United the chances. He was coming for crosses from corners and stuff like that. He was amazing today, Adrian. That, for me, is one of, if not his best performance in a Liverpool shirt. He's not played for a while, and what a way to reintroduce yourself. But he's not my man of the match. I don't think Sheffield United had enough chances against Adrian for me to think that he's a man of the match, because there were a few players on the pitch who did have a better game than him. One in particular, and I'll get onto that one in a moment. Okay, sorry. So it's my friend sending me a would you rather. Robertson then. I would give Robertson a 7.5. The only problem I had today with Robertson was his passes across goal. A little bit overhit. Particularly that one to Mo Salah. But he was trying to get forward a lot, which is what I like to see from a fullback. He was almost playing more like a wing back today, Robertson. His actual crosses from the left to get into the box to players were good, but when he was trying to drill them across low, they had too much power on them, is what I'm trying to say. He was even taking shots for himself. One he spooned over the bar, and one his header slammed straight into the ground. So in an attacking sense, it wasn't brilliant in terms of actually finishing, but Jesus. Alright, now we're going to move on to Ozan Kabak, and I'm going to give him a 6.5. I thought he made some brilliant challenges today, but he's clearly still settling. And I don't know what happened with that own goal. But I don't know what happened with the own goal. Fortunately, it was disallowed for offside. He was offside, but it was very narrow. He needs to be careful. Right, now we move on to Phillips. Also gets a 6.5, just for the same reason as Kabak. Looks very, very shaky. Couldn't handle Oliver McBurnie. Not McBurnie, Oliver Burke. Couldn't handle Oliver Burke. I don't know if it's just because of his pace, I don't know whether he just wasn't being physical enough. I don't know, but he couldn't handle him. And he let too much get past him today. Trent, 8.5. Brilliant from Trent. He was getting down that right-hand side. He was playing the balls into the box. He was taking shots on for himself. pretty much everything Trent Alexander-Arnold did today
was good.
But he's still not my man of the match. Believe it or not, there is someone on that pitch that played better than Trent today. Ronaldo, 7.5. I thought he led by example until Milner came on and took the armband. He did very well today, Gini. Just sometimes, a bit like Mo Salah, tried to do a bit too much for himself. Yeah. Oh, Ipswich just sacked Paul Lambert. Oh, it's mutual consent. Okay. That's weird. Now, Curtis Jones. 9. Curtis Jones gets a 9. It was almost as if everything he touched tonight turned to gold, pretty much. And he got himself a goal as well. Almost went out, but Trent did very well to keep it in. But it was a very solid performance from Curtis Jones. One of, if not his best, in a Liverpool shirt. He really showed his talent and potential today, Curtis Jones. And that is what we want to see. That is a legend in the making. That is what we want to see. Curtis Jones is one of the most promising, if not the most promising players we have. Let's keep it that way. What a performance. I'll go to Mane, 7.5. Much better than the last few games. However, still not as good as we know Sadio Mane can be. Mo Salah, 7. I thought he was ghosted today at times. Though when he came forward, he showed a clear attacking intent. Once again, it's the old remedy, isn't it, with Mo Salah? Quite a lot of the time, he tries to do too much for himself. And today is another one of those times where that happened. He tried to do too much for himself and it didn't pay off. Roberto Firmino gets an... He does get an 8. I'll give Roberto Firmino an 8. Purely for the fact that he was creating chances. And he was getting into the positions. He would have got an 8.5. Had the goal have been his. It's unfortunate that the goal wasn't his, although on replay it did show that it was going quite a distance wide. So it is an own goal, unfortunately. Had that been his goal, he would have got an 8.5. The only thing really that disappointed me today about Roberto Firmino was that chance, that one chance in the first half where, who was it that struck it initially? I think it was Wijnaldum had a shot. It was parried away by Ramsdale. And Firmino tries to play it across the box to Mane. Just put your foot through it into the top left corner. That's a goal. That's 1-0. That's the only thing that disappointed me today about Roberto Firmino. But that and a few of his touches were off. But it doesn't really matter because he recovered the ball pretty much every time that happened anyway. But out of the front three, he showed the most attacking intent today, Firmino. And haters will say, why Firmino? He was shit. He really wasn't. He really wasn't shit today. But he does need to start taking his chances a bit more. And he would have got a higher rating had he took them. Now we move on to the substitutes. We only made 2 subs today. My charger's having a spasm. Can you hear it? Stopped. That was weird. That was so weird. James Milner, 7. Didn't really see that much of him. Would have got a 6.5 if his passes were poor, but they weren't. He was putting in some good passes. Naby Keita, I'll give him a 6.5 just because I didn't really see anything from him. And quite a lot of the time when he came forward, he gave the ball away. Now, another spasm. Stopped. This is what I will say. Just ignore that. This is what I will say about Curtis Jones. Stop taking him off. He needs to play a full match, Curtis Jones. We finally ended the curse today of losing after Curtis Jones was taken off. But don't risk that again. No, in all seriousness, why did he take Curtis Jones off today? He was having the game of his life, really. Can you stop? Can you stop? He was having the game... Stop! Stop it! All right, start. He was having the game of his life today, Curtis Jones. He should not... Oh, my God! He should not have gone off today, Curtis Jones. Stop it. I will pick a man of the match from Sheffield United's point of view, and it's not difficult at all. Aaron Ramsdale. That first half was absolutely ridiculous. He made 5 brilliant saves in that first half to deny the likes of Mo Salah, Gini Wijnaldum, Roberto Firmino. There were other players that were having chances against him as well. I can't remember who the other two were. Trent was one of them, wasn't he? Who was the other one? It wasn't Thiago. I think Firmino might have had 2. Oh, I can't remember. My individual thoughts on the team performance today. As a team, stop it. Thank you. As a team, they were brilliant. I won't hesitate to admit that. They were absolutely brilliant. They were brilliant as a team today. Oh, that's enough now. Yeah, they were brilliant as a team today, Liverpool. They actually looked like they wanted to win a game. They actually look like they're in a race for top four rather than a relegation scrap, which they've looked like for the last few games. Big challenge on Thursday night, you know, Chelsea coming to Anfield, which has been somewhat of a playground, really, for every other team that's come here since. Who was the last team that we beat there? Tottenham, that was it. The last time we failed to lose to at Anfield was West Brom in a 1-1 draw. But yeah, overall, fantastic performance. Man of the match, Curtis Jones. I have nothing else left to say on the matter. But get Diogo Jota back as quick as we can. We need him in that attack. That could have been 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 if Jota was in that attack today. And I'm not saying replace one of the front three. Change the formation. Jota is a number 9. Play Jota as a number 9. Play Jota as a number 9. Did that sound like I said Jota is a number 9? I said Jota as a number 9. It sounded like I said is. Jota as a number 9. He's played there before. He's filled in before. He's seen him play there with Wolves. I don't think he's played there yet with Liverpool, but we know he can play there. Or if not that, Salah as a number 9. Switch Mane out to the right. And put Jota in his preferred position on the left wing. Or put Jota on the right. Either way, Firmino needs to play as a cam. We, as Liverpool fans, can see that Firmino will blossom as a cam. I know he's 29. But he's only going to get better if he plays in his natural position. It's not FIFA. He's not going to start declining at the age of 30. He can get better even as he gets older. Look at Ronaldo. Look at Messi. Lewandowski even. Was he 32 now and he's just getting better every game? Is he 31 or 32? I think he might be 31 actually. No, he is 32. I was right. But he just gets better every game, Lewandowski. And that's what Firmino can do. If he plays in his natural position. Bloody annoying, that thing. Shut up! I just knocked out the sofa. Who cares? Oh my God, I can still hear it! Anyway, I'm going to end it here before I get too triggered with my dickhead of a charger. Yeah, see you in a bit.